Right guys, we have updates regarding the modems for the 15 series, and also my thoughts on the whole USB-C situation with these phones, and so let's delve into it. So obviously, there's been tons of talk regarding Apple's in-house modems debuting with the 2023 iPhones, and Qualcomm themselves initially told us they would only produce 20% of the modems for the 2023 iPhones, and so that led us to believe that maybe the older iPhones would stick with Qualcomm's modems, but the flagship iPhone 15 series would get the upgrade to Apple's in-house modems. However, Qualcomm now tells us that no, that's not going to be the case. They are still producing a vast majority of the modems for the 2023 iPhones. And so that indirectly does tell us Apple's delayed the release of their in-house modems. And yeah, Quo has been telling us about this, and Gurman in this new report does tell us Apple's been facing overheating issues with the in-house modems, and so they're sticking to Qualcomm instead. And honestly, I'm glad about this because do remember that Apple did buy out Intel's modem business, and their in-house modems are based on their technology, which of course was not that great to begin with. Back when Qualcomm and Apple had beef, there were Intel modems inside iPhones, and they were pretty abysmal. I remember the 11 and the 10S having a lot of modem issues. And so yes, I'm glad Apple and Qualcomm are now best friends. They reached a settlement, and they're using Qualcomm modems in these iPhones, because ultimately, Qualcomm's modems are great. So yes, Apple, take your time with those modems. Please make them a lot better than Intel's modems. Until then, I'm happy with Qualcomm's technology, because with the iPhone 14 series, I've had no issues with the 5G and 4G performance. And it seems Qualcomm is testing the modem we're gonna see with the 15 series, that's been dubbed the X75 modem. So yeah, ultimately this is fantastic news, but I will say that I'm excited to see what Apple does with their own modems, because obviously we've seen the efficiency of Apple's chips, and so if battery life could be a lot better when using 5G with Apple's in-house modems, that would be great. So now let's move on to USB-C for the 15 series. So yes, in case you weren't aware, the European government has now enforced a law that by the end of 2024, all devices should have one common USB-C port. Now, Greg Joswiak said they'll comply with this, and so many have thought this means we're getting USB-C with the iPhone, and leakers have also said that yes, we should see this change with the 15 series. However, there has been YouTube videos from big creators basically telling us that this might not be the case, and Apple could go portless. And I have discussed this in the comments, but now let's talk about it here, because yes, there does seem to be a loophole that Apple can use and go portless with the iPhone. So the law says if the device has wide charging, it does need a USB-C port, and Apple can simply work around that and give us a portless iPhone instead, right? Well, yes, technically that is the case, but after some digging, I did find that devices that are exempt from this rule have to be too thin or too small. So of course, the Apple Watch would not apply to this rule because it would be way too small to have a port, but Apple really can't argue the same for the iPhone because it is big enough and thick enough to accommodate a port. Also, with the press release from the European government, I did see they said wireless charging is fine, but of course, the device should provide a USB-C port alongside it. So yeah, basically further clarification is needed, but ultimately I don't think Apple can get away with going portless because the whole goal of this law is, of course, to give every device, particularly smartphones, a common charger across the boards. And so I doubt the EU is going to be fine with Apple going portless and using a proprietary standard like MagSafe on the iPhone instead. Now, yes, technically, once again, MagSafe is Qi charging, which is a very common standard, but considering one of the key points of the law is to give all mobile phones the same physical charging ports, I just have my doubts Apple's gonna easily go portless. And also do remember that going portless does have its fair share of issues. For example, ProRes, how are you gonna transfer that without a physical port? AirDrop does ultimately have its limitations. Also, do remember that many cars offer wired CarPlay, so of course, going portless is gonna make that feature completely redundant, and consumers can't just go out and buy a new car like, of course, they do with a new phone. Also, Apple does promote things like Apple Music Lossless, and that needs a wired connection, so Apple offering a service you can't use on their main device would not make a ton of sense. Now, ultimately, I do wanna mention I'm pretty indifferent about this because I don't use the port that much in the first place. I primarily use wireless charging, so I can go portless. I just don't think it's going to be easy for Apple to do that. And I think the European government's main law is to give us a physical common charging port for all devices. Anyways, let's delve into your comments. So LA Rams fan says, it would be nice if we saw red color for the 15 Pros. And I think this is the color everyone wants. We've been waiting for this for years, and there has been talk that maybe Apple can't achieve the stainless steel finish they want with a red hue, and if that's the case, I actually would not mind gold sides. An Iron Man edition, I guess, I think that would be pretty great. But let's pray the titanium chassis actually gives us a red finish, and we do get a Pro iPhone in product reds. So Opus Digital Audio says, the 10 was a beautiful design and I completely agree with this. In fact, I'm hoping Apple can switch up the design on a regular basis and give us rounded edges for some years and flat edges for other years. So Dominic says, if Apple keeps the 3x and adds a second telephoto, the periscope lens, for 10x optical zoom on the 15 Ultra, they should have a new quad camera design. I think it's time for a new camera design. Now, I do know Android phones offer this, but personally, I doubt Apple's going to do this. I definitely think the periscope lens is going to replace the 3x, and Apple's simply going to give you the option for 3x by either zooming into the main sensor like they do with the 2x, or of course combining data from the main lens and the periscope to give you that 3x. I believe that's what Google does with their phones, and the optical zoom looks great. And so yes, Apple should implement the same with the 15 series. And as for the camera design, I doubt we're going to see quad cameras, because the triple lens camera has become iconic, with many phones looking the same on the front. I think Apple wants to maintain that look on the back. But also, of course, Apple rarely changes the back of the iPhone in the first place, and especially when they don't need to, I doubt they're going to give us any changes on the back of the device. So yes, while we should see periscope zoom, the 15 Ultra on the back should look the same for the most part. So Michael says, I would love to see Thunderbolt on the 15 Ultra, and I think many consumers would, because if you're going to use ProRes, transferring that footage over Lightning is going to be a pain. So of course, implementing Thunderbolt on the iPhone and making these transfers super quick would be appreciated. So James N says, will haptic buttons work with the case? And I'm not sure about this. The worst case scenario, cases can just have cutouts on the sides of the device for the haptic buttons. Anyways, that's about it. But of course, tell me your thoughts regarding this in the comments. Anyways, thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to like and subscribe for the latest Apple news and rumors. Check out the video above on details regarding the M2 iPad Pros. And on that note, see ya peeps.